Welcome back, guys. I'm just gonna go over stats real quick, I guess. Maybe standings. I suck. We'll go over stats real quick. Actually, we'll just go down the side right here. We're in week 3. Kyler Murray, Mac Jones, Daniel Jones, Nick Chubb, Alvin Kamara, Jonathan Taylor, leading rushers. Receiving leaders, Robbie Anderson after he murdered me, Kenny Galladay, Jameson Crowder, sack leader, Joey Bosa with 6, Emmanuel Ogbah 5, Brian Burns 4, interception leader, Jordan Whitehead with 3, Julian Love with 2, tackle leader, Logan Wilson. We got the Bears this week. That's how the rankings are. Not looking good for us, man. We got to get something going. Hey, I appreciate everybody. See y'all in Chicago. Yes, sir. Welcome to week 3.
They say summer is the time to live in Chicago. Well, that's extended into autumn as we are ready to roll under blue skies at Soldier Field. Today, it's week 3, and we've got a good one in store. Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, you look at this Bears team entering play. The losers their last time out, so they'll look to make amends here.
And one of the best ways you can do that is to be at home, and they are. They're going to try and ride that home crowd and that wave of emotion to a victory in this one.
Meanwhile, for the Lions here, an early season tilt, and when it's an early season tilt, should be ready to roll.
Well, let's face it, the aches and pains haven't really set in yet, and both teams eyeing a really good start to get things going.
Let's do it. Come on, boys. We need to pull a dub this week.
Selection in 2019 out of Washington State.
Would you say that last week's performance by him, workmanlike in terms of numbers?
One touchdown, one pick, but obviously a loss.
Yeah, and that's the bottom line for him. All he cares about is how do we find a way to win the game. Maybe leans on a few other parts of the offense and hopefully springs a receiver or two free.
Keep it together, offense. Keep it together, offense.
Let's start on the ground with Montgomery. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. The numbers on the ground for Montgomery in last week's affair. 15 carries, 116 yards, and a trip to the end zone.
Just an excellent performance from them on the ground last week, and that speaks to an offense that is operating at a high level.
Oh!
That man running the ball, he's just seeing the field so well. But don't forget about his offensive line. They've really asserted their will out there and are confident they can repeat it again this week.
First down, here's the run to Montgomery. And he's across the 43, extra yards to the 43. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2. Read option, here's Montgomery. Get it out to midfield. They'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, and a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you gotta like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs, established what they wanted, the running game. And guess what? They also got their lead guy running it pretty well, too.
Keep
room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now Montgomery running right.
Come on.
He doesn't find a ton of space following the display of quick feet down just inside the 45. That time the right guard sending him backwards.
And so many different types of guys rotate in on the defensive line now depending on situations. You can get the bulky guy, the fast guy. No matter what, though, you can't hold him.
Minshew's throw complete here to Komet. And they're going to get this up to midfield. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw.
Golly.
And that's complete. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 36.
Damn.
They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. Montgomery back to the ground. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Minshew sets to throw. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. Here's Minshew.
Oh, give me that. Yes, sir.
So a big defensive play there on the opening drive, no less, as they make the interception and bring it back for the score.
And I think
that's what I'm talking about.
They want to be disruptive, and you know they're going to take some chances.
Well, sometimes it can burn you, but right there, it paid off.
Uh-oh. Okay.
Woo. And that makes the score 7-0. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six.
That's what I'm talking about.
Taken in at the three. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. You see David Montgomery heading back out to begin the drive. And no doubt he's come out of the gate strong. Only in week three, and you see the numbers thus far.
And we always talk about identity, setting a tone, you know, getting the groundwork laid for the season or for a game. And that's what they've done with the running game so far. It reminds me of when I first went to the University of Tennessee. And believe it or not, I was a quarterback for a day and a half. And the first practice session, the first play we ran was 28 pitch, which is a toss sweep. And I remember the offense coordinator saying, that's our identity, that's our bread and butter, that's the basis of our offense. We got to get that down right here, right now. I think we're seeing some of that in this running game here.
So did you not get that down, and that's why you were moved to the defense, or what?
I don't know for that reason, but I do know I saw a couple of guys throw, and immediately they were saying, you know, you need to learn how to back up.
Hey, you turned into a heck of a DB, though, partner.
Gardner Minshew out here running like Michael Vick.
Just before the 35. A big time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down. They'll try the middle with Montgomery. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Throwing on first down, it's Minshew. Over the middle, it's complete. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16.
I'll tell you what, looks like he shook up that pick six just behind us. Just defensive backs. Quarterbacks utilize that as well. Much more confident throw right
zone now. They'll look to throw. They'll buy some time right. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. Coming up on a second and six. Now again, running right is Montgomery. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. This will be play number 9 of the drive here as they need 4 yards on third down. Looking to throw it, Minshew. And this is going to be...
That's what I'm talking about. That's a stop.
Nice tight coverage. They certainly recognized how important it was to bring up fourth down here.
The kick by McManus is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they are able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
So here are the Lions now coming out for their opening drive. They'll have the speedy Tyrod Taylor calling the shots, the former Virginia Tech Hokie.
And frankly, this is the type of game that a great quarterback relishes. 0-2, on the road, everything's against him and his team. No one can expect them to win. Sometimes you band together real tight in that situation, and if he plays really well, they've got a chance to get that done.
He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31.
Well, that's just going to piss him off.
Here's the ex-Florida Gator, LaMichael Pirine. Yeah, he'll fight for a couple as the tackle is made at about the 32. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. And I don't think he got there, no. They run, it's Williams. And this will wind up a Lions first down as he's able to get this up past the 40.
If he writes a book in the offseason, he ought to title it Undaunted, because where he is on the field, back on his own side, and goes for it and gets it, I gotta give it to him on that one.
Yeah, only thing you can justify it with is it was only a few inches that they needed. If it's 4th and 2, probably doesn't do it. Hey, he got it. Give him credit.
Yeah, but if they don't pick it up,
then you're in trouble.
Yeah, they're giving points to the other team at that stage.
Right back to Swift again on 2nd down. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. After 1, 7-3 the score on EA Sports.
I like it.
The Lions with the football here to begin the second quarter, as they've got it with a 3rd down coming up. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They'll try and run here with Swift. On a determined run there as he's going to take this all the way down near the 40. It's a gain of 10 for the Lions and a 1st down. The Lions at 0-2 here to begin the season. And listen, they made their share of mistakes in these first 2 games, CD, but talking to them in the days leading up to this one, doesn't seem like they've lost any confidence.
I would agree with that. And what they told us was that they weren't planning on making any drastic changes. They didn't see the need to shake things up. They were going to continue to plow ahead. They thought they had the right guys on the team and in the locker room. But they do have to start winning some games.
First down marker at the 30.
Okay, St. Brown.
From the shotgun, it's Taylor.
Damn. Drilled it.
And he His kick is good. He got every bit of that one, as it's good from 56 yards out. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3.
So no penalty. That's fucking wild.
And from what I've seen so far, Brandon, I think they've been the better of the two teams here in the first half. So even though you want the touchdown, I think that's a nice job there to put 3 points on the board.
And they will not get a chance to return this one, as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. Early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game. But I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally, because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated, because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice. But at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
Call it an 8-yard gain. Much better shape now on third and just a yard. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll try to throw for it with Minshew. That's Williams. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to convert, albeit not by much, on third and a yard.
And that one was a lot of fun right there, because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
And he is going to lose.
That's what I'm talking about.
2 yards the loss, second and 12. Well, he's had success running the football in this one. Yeah, that's undeniable. But that time, the defense was on to it.
And, partner, I think the more you see a play like this, the more they're able to diagnose it quicker and easier for them to defend it. I think you have to dress it up a little bit and show maybe some different formations.
Damn.
And getting this just shy of midfield is at the 49. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Now Minshew. That's complete to Mooney. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line. From the gun, it's a give to Montgomery. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's third and a yard. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Komet. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 28. 14 yards through the air. Caught the D off guard on third and one. A give to Montgomery out of the gun. To about the 26 here.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them, because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
The kick by McManus is good, and that'll bring him back within 4. Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the 3.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit
to
the defense as well.
10-6, boys.
To a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put 3 on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
Back onto the field come the Lions for their second overall drive. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them 3. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it. And he goes out and gets a job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well. On third down, here comes Swift. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 41 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. On first and 10, it's Swift. And he's got it across midfield and into Bear territory. The tackle made there by Linval Joseph. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Once again, it's Swift. He juked him. And he's got this down to the 35. It's a gain of 14 and a first down for Detroit.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Right there.
Williams going to get it again on 2nd down. About 3 yards there to the 27. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. To throw is Taylor.
Huh.
A bullet throw, but incomplete.
Passing lanes, forcing the incompletion, and bringing up 4th down.
Oh, my. Fuck.
And this will stay a 4th.
Damn it.
Boy, 4th and 2, this crowd was urging them to go. Instead, they settle for the field goal try.
Damn, man.
Brandon, yeah, football coach won't let the crowd dictate how he calls a football game. He stuck to his guns. But after the miss, now there's 70,000 coaches in the stands thinking they were right.
He's going to air one out. And incomplete on the deep ball. From the 34, they'll come to the line on 2nd and 10. Out of the gun is Minshew. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. Going up top. And that is incomplete.
Thank God.
Difference on that play, but one thing to keep in mind, here in the early part of the year during a day game, the sun does play a factor on deep balls.
On 2nd and 10, Minshew. They'll set up the screen to Montgomery. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's 3rd and 10. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
So many screen passes are the result of excellent acting by everyone. But sometimes the guy who's getting the ball tips the play off. The running back, because he's eager to get the pass, and sometimes he doesn't act very well about whether he's going to block or leak out or whatever. And I think that they saw that, and that's why they're able to get to him.
Now another timeout called for by the offense, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Again, Minshew looking to throw. Going to throw right side here, complete. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
Well, there wasn't much there with that hitch route. They didn't gain what they expected. But sometimes when you call a hitch, you really don't have an alternate to go to. You don't have a second route to throw it to. So sometimes you have to rifle in there and hope for the best.
And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line.
They certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
The kick by McManus is good. And that gets him back within a single point. It's now
10-9, baby.
So he's been a busy man.
What a game.
That's 3 field goals for him now.
And not just 3 field goals, but 3 for 3. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, they've still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
This one fielded at the 5. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. A Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they'll have time for one play. That's it. 3 seconds to go before intermission. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. So we have reached halftime with the visiting Lions taking the lead to the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Time to give you folks at home a look around the NFL on this first official weekend of fall. So let's get to it. We'll begin up at U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. And in the second quarter, it's the Vikings who are out on top. Kirk Cousins has thrown a touchdown pass. From there, we head over to the Pacific Northwest, check on the Seahawks at home in Seattle. And this one going the visitors' way, as the Texans have the lead in that one. Davis Mills, the Stanford man, with 2 touchdown passes. Finally, let's get out to Southern Nevada, see what's happening with the Raiders at home in Las Vegas. And they currently trail in that game against the visiting Patriots. Mac Jones with a couple of touchdown passes. Time now for a check of the next-gen stats in that first half for the Lions.
Man, oh man.
Success on the ground, and with the lead going into the second half, they'll no doubt be looking to keep it going. Meanwhile, for the Bears, there's a look at what they were able to do throwing the football, and they'll need to get things in gear as they trail here at the break. These two teams currently going over their final halftime adjustments. We are just about set to get back to it in the second half. And for the call, let's go back to Soldier Field and Brandon Godden.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one still anyone's.
Here we go.
We welcome you back.
10-9, baby.
The Lions in the lead, and they're going to get the football first as well as the second half is underway.
Oh.
And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. So here are the Lions to take over. They lost 2 straight coming in, but good news for them right now. They've got the lead and the football. Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games. And traffic, and it's intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it. And then chop at the 32-yard line. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10.
Guess it's Malik time.
They'll try and start this drive in the air.
Give me that.
Across his body and it's intercepted. Picked off by Amani Oruwariye. And the Lions are going to take over at their own 11-yard line.
Partner, I think this one went awry very simply because he overestimated his arm strength and his ability to fit it anywhere he wants to. A lot of quarterbacks do that and often pay the price.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it 1st and 10. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
3rd down, it's Willis.
Oh, no.
Life is one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Jaquan Brisker, and
they'll have
a setup in the red zone at the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's complete right side to Komet. Call it a gain of 6 on the play. Minshew's going to keep it himself. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up 1st and goal. Play action, it's Minshew. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game
that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. They'll go play action here with Minshew. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So they opted to pass for it on third and goal. Let's see what they do on fourth and goal.
Well, I think they threw it with the idea that if they didn't get it, they would go for it on fourth and goal.
Oh, yes, that's a stop!
They're going to have to call it right now. No field goal here.
Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. They start the drive on the ground. It's Williams. And a nice pickup as this one gets him
9 yards. Man, that was a good stop right there.
And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. 2 yards, good enough for a first. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. And he'll get this to the 22. So they began the play at the 11, and it's a gain of 11. First down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And able to give one man the slip there as he works his way forward for about three. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. They will run straight ahead with Swift. They'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. On third down, here's Williams. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Up the middle, it's Williams. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. Now they'll look to Willis to pass it here. That throw taken in by Jameson Williams. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 44-yard line. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Well, we saw a lot of negative plays that resulted in plenty of lost yardage in the first half. And that trend is continuing here.
That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. And connecting here with DJ Shark. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 27-yard line. A good pickup there of 20 yards.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Down to the 25. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9. Here's Piron. And he's going to take this down close to a first down at about the Bears' 18 yard line. Now Piron. He's going to be a yard short.
Oh my God. Come on, man. Fuck.
Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here. So it looks like we've got a lion that's shaken up. Hopefully, obviously, nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break.
They'll start by running the option to the right. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. From the gun, Minshew to throw.
And this one is incomplete.
The story of this game continuing to be the defenses, because the offenses, they're finding it difficult to establish any rhythm whatsoever.
I like how you come to us in praise of defense, Brandon, because that's exactly right. That was an incompletion for us there, but we've seen it throughout this game. Both of these defense coordinators, they're a step ahead of their offensive counterparts.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll look to throw. And this will be caught by Mooney. And they will rally and stop him short of the first down.
That's a stop.
Him to the ground at the 26. Here's Brett Kern now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. He punted four times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return, and the Lions will take over. Detroit's offense ready to take over. This game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive.
Damn.
That play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Willis now off of play action. That's caught by the big tight end, T.J. Hockenson. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing just enough. Spring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Swift going to try up the middle. And not able to break away this time, as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss.
They're just going to blitz the whole time? All right.
From the gun,
oh, shit.
And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here, he throws it away. And now it's third.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play. And he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. And not much happening there. He's taken down, but a late penalty flag in the backfield. This looks like a roughing call. Well, they were setting up the screen, CD, a lot of free runners, and they got there late, and the penalty ensued.
Yeah, somehow it didn't get into their brains that it was a screen, right? Instead of pulling off and chasing the ball downfield, they kept going towards the quarterback and knocked him down way late. That draws the penalty flag each and every time.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Second and 8 coming up. They run out of the gun with Swift. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 99 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long. This offense so far on third down, not quite 50%, 4 for 9. This time they face a 3rd and 2.
God damn it. Oh my God! Oh my God!
But it did not. It's no good. And this is going to remain a one-point game. So points so crucial at a time.
God damn it!
But this kick off the goalpost, and that'll keep the score right where it is.
Yeah, it wouldn't have made this a two-score game, but any cushion this late definitely would have helped. Now they need to ask their defense for another stop, and that's going to require some work.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. On second and 10, it's Minshew. And his throw is incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outside. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a 3rd and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
Open man is Komet, the tight end. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
conclusion. Up the middle, it's Montgomery. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Minshew going to try and run. On a determined run there as he's going to take this all the way down near the 40. Nice pickup. 10 yards and a first down on the keeper.
Who the fuck would have known Gardner Minshew is going to be beating me on read options?
Minshew sets to throw. He's going to let this go. Back of the
what a beautiful pass.
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
To throw on second and 10, Minshew. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35. Looking to throw it, Minshew. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he will have the Bears first down. He needed five. He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards. Going up the gut, Montgomery. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. From the 27, Minshew. Over the middle, and that's caught by Kmet. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. A loss of four that time on the sack, and it brings up second. Another try after the first down sack. Minshew. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16. In search of 8 yards on third down. They've already converted two of these on this drive, two for two. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. That winds up being a 4-yard loss and leads to fourth down. So on fourth down, trots the kicker in a big spot here. The kick by McManus is good. And they take the lead here by two, 12-10. After splitting the uprights, McManus to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And Detroit back in possession of the football. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ballgame. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. From the gun, here's Swift.
Oh, come on, left guard, what are you doing?
On that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment. Here's a handoff to Swift. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure you're back. You spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders.
Oh, my.
It's Devin Bush, the linebacker, who picks it. They take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. Throwing on first down is Minshew. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Kmet.
And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
Oh, man.
Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up.
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta, our apologies. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. Afitu Melifonwu up to make the tackle there. 2 minutes remain, and that's our score differential as well. 2 points here in the fourth quarter. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and seven. They'll keep pounding here with Montgomery. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down.
Come on. Jesus Christ. Man, oh man. Man. Damn.
So for the Bears, they get back in the win column as they move to 2-1 now on the year. And they will hit the road next week to take on the L.A. Chargers. Meanwhile, Detroit, the early struggles continue as they'll sink to 0-3. And they'll try to turn it around next week as they head to Atlanta for a matchup with the Falcons.
Fucking pathetic. Well, see y'all next week.